Evening, everyone. Very warm welcome to all. Our readings can be found on page 124, on page 4, page 20. Perhaps we envy the apostles who have been seen and experienced Jesus after he had risen from the dead. There is no reason to envy us if we have faith. We too experience him as risen, alive, present, and shaping our life. If we have faith, we know that he is there when we suffer, mishaps, and failures, or when we rejoice. If we have faith, we know Jesus is there when we share and yield our future, and especially when we eat together on the table of the Eucharist. We stand.
Give us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
And we are witnesses of these things. And so is the Holy Spirit, whom God has given to those who obey Him. And they charged the apostles not to speak in the name of Jesus, and let them go. Then they left the presence of the council, rejoicing that they were counted worthy to suffer this honor for the name. Response to the responsorial songs. I will extol you, Lord, for you have raised me up.
I will extol you, Lord, for you have raised me up.
I will extol you, for you have raised me up, and have not let my enemies rejoice over me. O Lord, you have lifted up my soul from the grave, restored me to life from those who seek to repent. Sing songs to the Lord, you faithful ones. Give thanks to His holy name. His anger lasts a moment, His favor all through life. At night there are tears, but at dawn comes joy. I will extol you, Lord, for you have raised me up. Hear, O Lord, and have mercy on me. Be my help, O Lord. You have changed my mind. Lord my God, I will thank you forever. I will extol you, for you have raised me up. A reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, looked and I heard around the throne and the living creatures and the elders the voice of many angels, numbering myriads.
Jesus said to them, "Children, have you any fish?" coded language was understood by the whole tribe. And the book went to make the point a little bit further on that many cultures have this sort of coded language to deal with profound emotions. The particular phrase that this island tribe used was, well, let's have a nice cup of tea.
And that profound understanding.
simply sums everything up that he has ever done, his death and resurrection included, the effect of all of it on his disciples with those simple words, "Let's have breakfast." A few grilled fish and a few bread. And there it is, all restored. And the disciples are prepared then to receive the final and the most profound of all that Jesus has ever said, given here in English simply with two words: follow me. Follow me through miracles. Follow me through teaching and preaching. Follow me through death. Follow me to the new life of the resurrection and the fullness of the kingdom of God. It is only in that space, in that disturbing space, where the disciples return to ordinary life after such an extraordinary time with Jesus, that the ground is prepared in their own consciousness and in their own souls to hear those words of Jesus one last time. It's those simple words, "Let us have breakfast," which draws them into the receptivity of hearing those words, "Follow me." We have a greater privilege than those disciples, for we have Jesus at our worship and at our gathering, as often as we come together here as a church. And there's the simple invitation: come, eat some bread, drink some wine. And through that simple invitation, "Come to the banquet," we receive the fullness of Jesus' presence into the heart of our own existence. And that is constantly renewed. That invitation happens over and over again. Every time we come here, it is like the disciples arriving on that beach and hearing Jesus say, "Let's have breakfast." Here he simply says to us, "Let's carry on." And that enables us to repair everything that has gone wrong, as Peter repaired what went wrong in his relationship with Jesus. And